Hi everyone, welcome you all. So in our previous videos, we have seen how to handle different type of dropdowns, like a dropdown is having select tag and a multi-select dropdown and bootstrap dropdown and auto suggest dropdown, right? So in the today's video, I'm going to show you something different type of dropdown. So which is normally called as hidden dropdown. That means the dropdown contains options, but those options are hidden most of the times. Okay. And those options we cannot directly inspect. We cannot directly get the locator for those options. Now, let me show you what is hidden dropdown. So for that, I'm trying to use this application. So let me capture and go back to your application. And first we need to log into this application. And once you log in successfully, then we need to go to PAM tab. Inside the PAM, you can see multiple dropdowns options. So you can see title, job title, employee status, okay, and subunit, include, multiple dropdown elements are there. And if I try to inspect this dropdown, you don't see the select tag for them. Okay, you can't see the select because this is also bootstrap element. So the additional thing is these options are hidden actually. If I click on this job title, you can see these options, right? These options are hidden. What does it mean? You can't directly inspect those elements. If I right click on this option, as soon as you right click, it is disappeared. Now, if I still trying to use selector hub also, you can't inspect this element internally. But selector hub is provided one good option called debugger. So by using this option, we can freeze that application for a few seconds. After that, we can capture the locator for those options. Okay, we will see how to handle that. So this is basically called hidden dropdown. So these options we cannot directly inspect. As soon as you're trying to inspect these options, they will disappear. Okay. So let us try to handle this dropdown through Playwright. So for that, I'm trying to open my VS Code editor. I already created one spec file under my test. The spec file name is hidden dropdown.spec.js. So in this, I already imported test and expert functions from Playwright test module. Now I created one test block and this is the page fixture and I'm launching the application here. So first we need to do login to that application. So for that, I have written this particular piece of code for login and it's very simple. So what we can do is we can just wait page.locator and this is the locator for the username input box and fill the value and then again get the password element and then fill the admin123 which is the password. And then get the submit button, click on the submit button. So these are the three steps I have done. And if I just start from the login, so these are the three steps I already done. So provided username, provided password, clicking on the login. So after successfully login, you can see admin123. So after successfully login, by default, it will show you the dashboard page. So this is our dashboard. Now we need to navigate to the PAM. So once you navigate it to the PAM, here you can see the dropdowns. So to navigate to the PAM, so I'm just clicking on this element. So this is for locator of that PAM. So I'm just using XPath here and then click on the option. So once you click on the PAM, this will open the personal information page here. Okay. So here you can see the different type of dropdown. So this is the job title is one of the dropdown. Now we are going to handle this. Okay. So the first thing is what we need to do is we need to, if you want to get these options, you need to first click on this job title element. So we need to perform the click on this particular box and then you will get these options. Okay. So to click on this button, so I have used one XPath which is already created and go back to VS Code Editor. After clicking on PM tab, and this is the dropdown actually. So it is very big hex path. Click on the dropdown. So here I provided the XPath locator for that particular dropdown element and perform the click action. So once you perform the click action, then other options will be available here like this. Okay. So from here, we need to select one of the options. So if you want to select one of the options, you cannot inspect these options directly. You cannot inspect them. So now what we need to do, we need to write proper locator, which will able to capture all the options which are present inside the dropdown. Okay. So for that, we have to inspect these options. We should able to inspect these options. But normally it is not possible because this is hidden drop down. We cannot directly inspect those elements. So now take the help of selector hub. You can just right click inspect, and now you got the selector hub. In the selector hub, you can see one feature called this one. So the debugger option, you can see here. Okay, this is the debugger option. Turn on debugger. So this option will very, very helpful whenever you deal with the hidden elements. Okay, so how to use this option is, first thing, we have to click on this debugger option, and within 5 seconds, you need to open this dropdown. And after 5 seconds, it will automatically freeze. Okay, so I'll show you how to do this. Now I'm just clicking on this turn on debugger. Immediately, whatever you want to do, you can just click on the dropdown and just freeze like this. See, after 5 seconds, automatically, your screen will be freezed. Now we can't do anything on the screen until unless you passed your debugger. Okay. Now go back to elements. Now we can inspect this element. You can simply see I'm able to inspect these options. Right. Now I'm trying to inspect one of the option like this, chief executive officer. So if I look at this, I want to write one common relate locator, which will able to match all the options. So if I look at here, each individual div is representing one option. So this is a div role actually. Inside the div role is a list box. And inside the div list box, there are multiple subdivisions are there. It's every option, there is one div tag is there. So we will write the locator from here, role equal to list box. I'm going to write one XPath. And I can say //dev/div. And I'm trying to use role attribute. You can say role equal to list box, role equal to list box, one element is matching. And inside this, inside the role list box, there are multiple div tags there, but actually the option is not there in the div. If you try to expand one of the div, and inside the div, there is a span tag. So inside the span, actual text is present. So I'm directly go to span. So 28 elements. So this is the right XPath which we have to use. Now I'm getting this XPath, and this is a common XPath we can use to capture all the options from the dropdown. Now go back, and here. So after clicking on the dropdown, we'll get all the options, right? So we will first wait for the options. So how to wait for the options? Waiting for options. It takes few seconds of time. So I'll keep some time here, waiting time. Waiting for options. Let me put comment here. Waiting for options. Okay, so for that I'm just waiting some time. So here await page dot wait timeout. Here I'll just wait for 3 seconds, more than enough. And after that, I want to capture those options. So to capture those options, what we can do is simply I can say await page dot. So again, we are getting multiple options. We say $ and write XPath locator, whatever we capture. So this will get you all the options into a variable. Now I can specify this as a const variable. So now again, we need to read each and every option from this, and whichever is matching, we have to select from that box. Simply I can say for inside the for loop, and I can say options, whatever options I captured above. So I specify the options. From the options, we have to get each and every option. So option of options, and this option is a variable. So in this loop, we are getting all the options already here. And I'm reading each and every option into this variable. And from this option, we have to capture the text. So in the previous examples, we already seen the same process. Await page dot await option dot text. Text content, right? So this will return the actual text of the option. And that I'm going to again store in a variable. I'm creating one variable, const job title. Okay, let's try to print those titles first, and then I will see how to select the option. I say console.log, I can say job title. So what we have done is simple. And here we click on the dropdown element, and all the options are displayed, and we waited for some time here. And after that, we captured all the options. They are basically hidden options. And now we are reading each and every option into this variable and getting the text content from every option. And then I'm just printing it. Okay. Now save it and then go to the terminal and execute the command. So npx playwright test, test underscore, my file name is hidden dropdown. Let me change the file name. Hidden dropdown. Perfect. Hidden dropdown dot spec.js. I'm trying to run on my only Chromium browser in headed mode. Let me try to execute. So it is launching my application. Login. Now go to PAM. Now you can see it is displaying all the options. So in the console window, we have just printed all the options coming from the dropdown. Right. So if I look at here, these are the options currently we have in the dropdown. Okay. Now we want to select one of the options from this. I can say, I just want to select QA engineer. So this option I want to select. Simply you can write and just comment this and simply write one if condition. If, so we already captured the job title, right? So with that, we have to compare if job title dot includes, and whatever you want to select, you can just specify this. If the job title dot includes QA engineer, then we need to await, and whatever option we captured here, we need to click on that option. So option dot click. Option dot click, and after, as soon as you click on that option, we can simply break the loop so that we don't need to go to the rest of the options. So after selection, I will just wait, put some wait time so that we can see whether it is successfully selected or not. So I can just put some wait time here, let's say 5 seconds. Okay, so now let us try to execute. So from the dropdown, I'm trying to select QA engineer. Let's go to the terminal and run it once again. Login, go to PAM tab. Now we can see from the job title, it should be selected QA engineer. You can see it is selected from QA engineer. Okay. So this is simply we can handle hidden dropdown. It is almost the same, even hot auto suggestion and hidden same, only the difference in the property, the behavior of the dropdown. So in the auto suggestion, so by default auto suggestion options are appeared, but we can easily inspect those options, right? In the auto suggestion box, the auto suggestion options, we can easily inspect, but in a hidden dropdown, we cannot inspect them. So for that, we are going to use this particular tool. So this particular selector hub debugger option, which will be helpful for us. Okay. So wherever you can see this type of dropdowns, hidden dropdowns, we can still use this option and you can start debugger and it will freeze your screen for some time and then you can inspect. After that, you can stop debugger, you can pause your debugger, and now again if you want to inspect, you cannot, it is disappear. Okay, so this is simple way we can handle hidden drop downs. Okay, so that's all for this video. In the next video, we'll discuss some other topic. Thanks for watching.